Okay, we're looking at the answer video for the last task. It's a fairly big task, so we'll just go through as quick as we can. The first question is just a right angle triangle, so it's just sine 50 equals opposite over hypotenuse, x is on the top, so it's multiply, and answer is to two decimal places, so 6.13 units. Next one, again, to draw a diagram. Okay, so that's the height we want. That's 4.3 degrees, and that's 1200, and that's the tree right angle. So that's a tan question. Equals opposite over hypotenuse. It's a multiply because x is on the top. Equals 90.2 meters, and so therefore the plane will make it. We'll clear by 10.2 meters. Okay, next question. Okay, so we're now into non-right angle trig, so in case you weren't sure what the diagram looked like, I'll put A, B, C, that's 30, that's 70, that's little C, that's 7. Okay, so angle C is the missing one, so it's just 180 minus the other two. So angle C is 80 degrees, and then C over sine 80, equals 7 over sine 30, C equals 7 times sine 80, sine 30, and when you put that in the calculator, you get 13.8 something units. Okay, next one is the bearings, find an equivalent bearing. Okay, so that's 0, 90, 180, 270, so we're there, 20 degrees to get the 290, so the missing angle is 70 degrees, so it's north, 70 west. Okay, next question. What is the bearing? Okay, so the bearing of B from A is either south 60 east, so south 60 east, or it's 120 true. In part B, okay, if that's 60, that's 30, so the second answer would be, so that's 30, because that's 60, so that's 60 as well, so it's north 60 west, or if that's 60, then that's 300 degrees, so that's 300 true. Okay, next one. Okay, so exact values, so this is in the second quadrant, so sine is positive. Okay, the formula is 180 minus theta equals 135, so theta equals 45, and then sine 45 equals 1 on root 2. Okay, part, we'll do this one next. So that is 2 1/4 pi, which means we've gone past the lap, so you're back into the first quadrant. So tan is positive, and tan of pi on 4 is the same as 1. Okay, sec is 1 over cos, 315. That is the fourth quadrant, so cos is positive. So 360 minus something equals 315, so theta equals 45. So cos 45 equals 1 on root 2, therefore 1 over root 2 is just root 2. Okay, so we've got 7 pi on 6, so cosec is 1 over sine, and we've got a minus sign in front of it. So 7 pi on 6 is 1 and 1 6 pi, so we've gone past the second quadrant, so we're in the third quadrant. Okay, so it's minus 1 over sine 7 pi on 6, so sine in the third quadrant is negative number, and the formula is 180 plus theta equals 7 pi on 6, so that should be pi, because we're in radians. Theta equals pi on 6, so we've got sine pi on 6 equals 1/2, so therefore what we've actually got is minus 1 over a negative number, and then it's a half. The two negatives make a positive, and then you flip that fraction, so you get a 2. Okay, next one. Okay, 2 yachts. Okay. 1 yacht is going 38 degrees, and it's 12K. The other one is going... So that is Izzy's yacht, tick, going at 038. And if that's 118, then that's 62. And that's travelling for 16K. Now 38 plus 68 is 90, which means that that angle's a right angle. Okay, and... It's 90, it's 100, sorry. 100 degrees, sorry. So that's not a right angle, so that's 80 degrees in there, beg your pardon. So we don't have a right angle, so we've got cosine rule, x squared equals 12 squared plus 16 squared minus 2 times 12 times 16 times cos 80, and then when you get that and square root it, you get 18.3 kilometers. Next question. Okay, soccer goal. So we've got the goal mouth is 7.32 meters. 13.6 to one post, and then it's 19.32 to the other post, and we have to find that angle there. So that's the cosine rule, so cos theta is 13.6 squared plus 19.32 squared minus 7.32 squared over 2 by 13.6 by 19.32, and then you go shift cos, and the answer is 16 degrees and 12 minutes. Okay, next one is area of a triangle. So it's a half AB sine C. So area equals a half AB sine C. So that's the angle, and that's A and B. So that number wasn't needed. So it's a half by 47 by 39 times sine 21. And that gives 328 to the whole number. Next question. The smallest angle will always be opposite the smallest side, so that's theta. So cos theta equals 6 squared plus 7 squared minus 5 squared, 2 by 6 by 7, and then you just inverse, get that number, inverse cos, and it's 44 degrees, 25 minutes. Next question. Okay, start of the formulas. So that's 4 quadrants, cos is positive, so cos positive in the first and the fourth quadrants. You've got a first quadrant, we just use our calculator. So the first quadrant, theta equals cos minus 1.6, which is 53 degrees to the nearest degree. And in the fourth quadrant, theta equals 360 minus 53 equals 307 degrees. Okay, so this was the harder one. Okay, so because we've got this bracket, so we've got to subtract pi on 4, so we've got minus pi on 4 less than equal to theta minus pi on 4 less than equal to 7 pi on 4. Okay, so we subtract 1. So sine is negative. So sine negative in the third quadrant, the fourth quadrant, but this angle is in the negative first quadrant. Okay, so they're the ones we have to check. So, sine, so, theta minus pi on 4, so that's an exact value, pretend it's positive, and so we get pi on 4 in the first quadrant, but we don't want first quadrant, so we use that answer. So therefore in the third quadrant, theta minus pi on 4, equals pi plus it, and then we add another one, so theta equals, ends up being 3 pi on 2. In the fourth quadrant, theta minus pi on 4, like in brackets, in the fourth quadrant equals 2 pi minus pi on 4, then we add pi on 4 to both sides, so we get 2 pi, and in the negative first quadrant, theta minus pi on 4 is just equal to the negative of that angle. So add 1 at pi and 4. So theta equals 0. So whenever you get an answer of 2 pi, you automatically get another answer of 0. So there's 3 answers. Okay, come across. Okay, which quadrant? So we're looking at. Oh, come on, get the pen. Okay, so the answer is in the second quadrant. Okay, so we know that sine squared plus cos squared equals 1. We've got sine squared equals 1 minus cos squared equals 1 minus 8 17ths squared. And when we do that, we get 225 and 289. So therefore sine equals plus or minus the square root of that number, which is plus or minus 15 over 17. But in the second quadrant, it's only the plus answer that we take because the sine is positive. And the question is, what's tan? So tan equals sine over cos equals 15 over 17 divided by cos, which is minus 8 over 17. So the answer is minus 15 over 8. Okay, next question. Okay, so then we've got another sine squared plus cos squared type question, but then we have to use the sum angles and the difference angles. So, sine squared beta plus cos squared beta equals 1. So sine squared beta equals 1 minus cos squared beta equals 1 minus 5 thirteenths squared, which is 144 over 169. So sine beta equals the square root of that number, which is just 12 thirteenths. We're in the first quadrant, so we just take the plus. So it would be plus or minus, but we just take the plus. Then we've got to do the alpha. So sine squared alpha plus cos squared alpha equals 1. We've got sine, so we need cos. It's 1 minus 3/5 squared, and that equals 16 over 25. So cos alpha equals the square root of that number, and we again take the plus, so it's 4/5. Okay, so now we're up to, we've got all the numbers, so we've got sine alpha, we'll do sine alpha is 3/5, cos alpha is 4/5, sine beta is 12/13, cos beta is 5/13. Okay, so they're the numbers we use. Okay, so the first one, change colour, change to orange. So cos alpha plus beta equals cos alpha, cos beta minus sine alpha, sine beta equals 4/5 times 5/13 minus 3/5 times 12/13, and so the answer is minus 16 over 65. Okay, so with the tan, we have to get, for the tan question, we have to get tan. So tan alpha equals sine over cos, so it's 3/4. Tan beta equals sine over cos, so it's 12/5. Tan alpha minus beta equals tan alpha minus tan beta over 1 plus tan alpha tan beta equals 3/4 minus 12/5 over 1 plus 3/4 times 12/5, and you put that in your calculator and you get minus 33 over 56. Okay, next one. Okay, so sine 105 is the same as sine of, is the same as sine of 60 plus 45. So it equals sine 60 cos 45 plus cos 60 sine 45 equals root 3 on 2 times 1 on root 2 plus a half times 1 on root 2 equals root 3 plus 1 over 2 root 2. Okay, next question. Okay, this one. Okay, so we had a right angle triangle here, so you had to divide it there. Okay, so the first thing you had to do is find that side, x. So x squared equals 2.5 squared plus 2.2 squared. And so x is 3.33 meters. And then we can find that angle so we can get the area of the triangle. So cos theta equals 4.4 squared plus 6.1 squared minus 3.3 squared over 2 by 4.4 times 6.1. So theta ends up being 32.08 degrees. So change colour. So that's triangle 1, that's triangle 2. Area of 1 equals a half base times height because it's a right angle triangle. So that's 2.75. Area 2 is a half AB sine C, which is a half times 4.4 times 6.1 times sine 32.08. So that ends up being 7.13 meters squared. So the total area equals 9.88 meters squared. And for the number of fish, 9.88 divided by 0.8 is 12.35. So we can have 12 fish. Okay, next one. Okay, so we've got a few questions to do with this. So theta gradients equals 50 pi over 180. And we have to do decimal places. So that's 0.873 radians. Length equals r theta. So that's 15 times 0.873 equals 13.1 centimeters. See the perimeter. Perimeter equals 2 radii plus the length of the arc. So that's 13.1. So that's 43.1. D. Area of the sector. Area equals half r squared theta, a half times 15 squared times 0.873, which is 98.21 centimeters squared. And so we're trying to find the area of the segments. So the area of the triangle unshaded is a half AB sine C. So 50, so that's 86.18. So therefore the area of the segment, which is the question, is the 98.21 minus the 86.18, which gives 12.03 centimeters squared. Okay, minute hand. Okay, so there's the minute hand, and it's going through that. So the first part is how long is that, and the second part is that question. So 60 minutes is 360 degrees. So 1 minute equals 6 degrees. So 16 minutes equals 96 degrees. 96 degrees is 96 times pi. 180, which is in the formula, so it's 1.6755 radians. So therefore the length of the arc is r theta, which is 20 times 1.6755, which is 33.51 centimeters. The shortest distance is the chord. Okay, so we've got 20. There's a couple of ways of doing it. I'll do it this way. That is 1.6755. So I could drop a line down, make a right angle triangle. So sine of half of it in radian mode is x over 20. So x or you could do sine, or you could do sine 40. You could make that a, you could make that 96 degrees, and then just you writing a triangle. So x ends up being 14.86 centimeters. So the chord is 29.73 centimeters. All right, next question. All right, so we've got 15 degrees there. We've got 100 meters to there. The whole angle there is 40 degrees. That's x. I think that's all we've got. Okay, so we know that this angle here is 25 degrees. There was another angle there. Oh yeah, that's 50 degrees. Okay, that's the other angle we have to have. So that's 25, so that's 130, which makes that angle up there 25 degrees. Okay, so that's the first one. So part B, we've got a triangle, x, 25, 130, 25, and that's 100. So x over sine 130 equals 100 over sine 25. So x is 100 times sine 130, sine 25, and that gives us the 181.26 meters. And then second part of the last part of the question, we've got a right angle triangle. It's 181.26 x, and that's 40. So sine 40 equals x over 181.26. Cross multiply, and that gives us 116.51 meters. Okay, next is the last part. Okay, so the x-intercepts are minus 1 and a double. So y equals, at the moment, x plus 1 bracket x minus 2 all squared. And we've got a y-intercept of 1. So 1 times minus 2 times minus 2 equals positive 4. But I've only got 2, so that means I must have a half of that function. Okay, next question. Alright, vertical asymptote, ASCII, is what can't this equals, so 3x minus 1, it can't equal 0, so we make it equal to 0, 3x equals 1, so x equals a third. Horizontal asymptote is just the number at the back, so it's just y equals 2. Okay, B, domain, all x except the asymptote. The range, all y except y equals 2. Okay, to sketch it, okay, we need to find the x-intercept. So the x-intercept, y equals 0. So we end up with minus 2 over 3x minus 1. Take the 2 across, so you get minus 2. 3x minus 1 times minus 2 equals minus 2, so the minus 2s cancel out to leave 1, so 3x equals 2, so x equals 2 thirds, y-intercept x equals 0, when you put that in, you get y equals, can't see the function again, minus 2 over minus 1 plus 2, which is 2 plus 2 equals 4. Okay, so let's do this quickly. So we've got 4, we've got 2 thirds. Come on. So we've got x equals 1 third, y equals 2. So it looks, I'm doing it a bit dodgy, but that's what it looks like. And y and x. Okay, next question. Okay, just got to substitute the value p2 in. So p2 equals 2 cubed minus 3 times 2 squared plus k times 2 minus 7 equals 8 minus 12 plus 2k minus 7 equals 2k minus 11. We know the answer equals 0, so 0 equals 2k minus 11. 2k equals 11. K equals 11 on 2. Alright, sketching a polynomial. We have to find the first factor, so eventually if you do x equals 2, y equals 0, so x minus 2 is a factor. So then we did x minus 2 into x cubed minus x squared minus 14x plus 24. I won't do the whole division, but you end up with x squared plus x minus 12, which is the same as x plus 4, x minus 3. So there's a lot of stuff to put in here. So the x-intercepts are 2, minus 4 and 3. The y-intercept from the original equation is 24. And so you end up so it's not a great sketch, but that's 2, that's 3, that's minus 4, that's 24, y, x. Okay, you have to have a closer sketch than I did. That's a dodge. Okay, next one, so on the hard questions. So x equals 1 is a x equals 1, so p1 equals 0, and x equals 2, which means p2 equals 0. So p1 equals 1 to the power of n, 2n minus 1, because all I'm just doing is putting in where the x's are, that's all I'm doing. 1 minus 2 to the n, plus 2 to the n, minus 2 to the n, so I just expand out. So 2 to the n minus 1, plus 1 minus 2 to the n, plus 2 to the n minus 2 to the n, and when you add up all those terms, you get 0, and the same with 2 to p2, so 2 to the n, 2 to the n minus 1, plus 2 to the m, 1 minus 2 to the n, plus 2 to the n, minus 2 to the m. Okay, so we multiply those, so we add the indices. Let's multiply. So we multiply those two, you add the indices. And then when you add up all those terms, you get 0. So therefore, x minus 1 and x minus 2 are factors. Okay, right, yeah. Multi-choice, so this will just bang it out. So the answers were that one, 53 degrees. Question 3, sine 53 east. Okay, 9 15ths, we use the sine ratio, 5 pi on 6, and 210 degrees. That's it. Bye.